welcome address. First of all, a huge thank you for having made to the last day of the 7-day online enrichment program on holistic development of teachers, organized by BOC College of Education in collaboration with the Tamil Nadu Teacher Education University. A special welcome to our principal, Dr. T. Kanagaraj, BOC College of Education, who will be delivering the valedictory welcome address. We welcome you. Our valedictory guest, Professor B. Balakrishnan, who is the registrar in charge of Tamil Nadu Teacher Education University, Chennai. We welcome you, sir. Next, I welcome Ms. Kavita, Assistant Professor, BOC College of Education, who will be there introducing the resource person. Welcome, ma'am. Next, I welcome Mr. A. Kingston, Assistant Professor in Commerce, BOC Chidambaram College, Tuticorin, who will be our resource person today. Welcome, sir. Next, I welcome Ms. Priya, Assistant Professor, BOC College of Education, who will our program moderator. Welcome, ma'am. Next, I welcome Dr. Guru Vasigi, Dr. Davasubha, Dr. Anthony Vinolia, Assistant Professors in BOC College of Education, who will be our program controllers. Welcome, dear ma'am. Next, I also welcome Dr. Lakshmi Shanmugam, Assistant Professor of Education of Psychology in Tamil Nadu Teacher Education University, one of the program coordinator, who will be delivering the word of thanks. Welcome you, ma'am. And to talk to it all, a huge welcome all the participants who have made this day to what it is. Once again, I welcome all. Thank you. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your pleasant welcome. The key to growth is the introduction of personalities into our consciousness. By this, I call upon Ms. M. Kavita, Assistant Professor in Physical Science, VOC College of Education, to introduce our today's resource person. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Priya, ma'am. Good morning, all. Communication is power. Those who have mastered its effective use can change their own experiences of the world and the world's experiences of them. All behavior and feelings find their original roots in some form of communication. As to it is a great honor for me to introduce our chief guest, Mr. A. Kingston, Assistant Professor in Commerce, BOC College, Tuticorin. He is such an aspiring personality, which is known from his career objective, which is aspiring for a career that places me in a challenging position to carry out my teaching, training, and interpersonal skills. Such an inspiring quote he has made in his objective. Verbal and communication skills, training and development skills, effective leadership qualities were his strong suit. He is having 2 years experience in teaching and handled 8 PG products. He also published many articles in research journal and also chapters in published in books. Since he is good at communication skills, he trained many students, bank employees, faculties on language skills. He is a certified trainer for central government course on sales and marketing. Today we are privileged to have an opportunity to listen to a trainer as a chief guest in this morning. On behalf of all gathered here, I welcome you, sir, to this 7-day online enrichment program on holistic development of teachers. Thank you.
Thank you, Kavita ma'am, for your candid introduction. A good relationship starts with good communication. To develop our good communication skills, let us adhere from our resource person, Mr. A. Kingston. The session is handed over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you, VO Chidambaram College of Education, for inviting me as a resource person. I think it's the second time that I've landed up here in this institution as a resource person. And it's good that our college is continuously doing so many webinars and so many personality development programs, even at the juncture of pandemic period. So happy to meet you all once again. And I'm sorry that I'm unable to share the screen at present. So I've sent the PPT to the organizers. Can the organizers share the PPT that I've sent? Is it audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Can the organizers share the screen that I've sent? Or can you please give me just 1 minute so that I can arrange another system and share the people?
Wait, sir. Dava ma'am. Dava ma'am.
Yeah, Priya ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes. Can you share the PPT for our resource person?
Yes, I can, ma'am. Just a second, I will.
Or just give me 1 minute, ma'am, so that I can arrange another system and share my PPT.
Okay, sir.
Before that, I request all the participants to mute your microphone and video for clarity of presentation. If you have any issues or questions, you can ask to the speaker through the chat box. Now the screen is visible, sir.
Then I'm sharing it from the other system.
Yes, sir. Your screen is visible.
Okay, madam. Shall I start?
Yes, sir. It's your pleasure.
Okay. Dear participants, and I'm so good to meet you all. And we're going to have glimpses over the developing academic communication. And you might wonder who this person is to talk about communication and what is the person is going to say about the kicking out the hindrances that we have. So first of all, let me tell you what my presentation is all about. In my presentation, I'm going to give you only four things. In every session, I used to give me what we are going to discuss in the very beginning itself. First of all, these are the four elements that we are going to talk today. I think my PPT is very visible now. Yes?
Yes, sir. It is visible.
Yes. First thing is that who am I to talk about it? And I still remember in the year 2015, in the beginning of 2015, I started an institution to teach people to, and I exclusively train people to speak English and Hindi. So I've come across quite a good number of people. If my remembrance is right, I might have come across more than thousands of people and exclusively. And fortunately or unfortunately, majority of the proportion of that crowd is teachers and exclusively from the people who are working in the company. People who work in the companies, they need business English, and people who are working in colleges and schools, they need academic English. So I think I'm capable of talking about it because I've come across quite a good number of people in this field, and they want to tell me, "Sir, I want to speak English. I understand English completely. When other people speak English, I'm able to understand. But when it comes to the matter of response, I'm unable to give it back." So coming across quite a good number of people in my experience, just 5 years of experience that I have in handling this kind of people and training them in to speak English, I think that I'm capable of talking about it. So now I have quite a good number of experiences that I've come across so far. So many of them, before I starting this session, I thought of giving you a poll, but I do not know whether if it works in Google Meet or not. I was having an institution and I've been training people to speak English, and there are so many barriers that they have put in front of me, and we are going to discuss those barriers as well today. The second thing is that how does a language associate with communication? If you look into the definition of communication, all it says is only one thing. It doesn't talk about language at all. seriously, and there are many professors might be here, and of course they are here, and you know that whenever, whatever the book that you may refer to, communication does not refer to a language at all. But then how we associate language with communication? What is communication at first? So now I'm talking, and there are about 126 people are hearing. I including myself, there are 126. They're all hearing. If I'm using, if my English is very tough, you know, I'm using all the standard vocabularies that I've learned. I'm using good, if I have correct fluency. Everything is right, you know, pronunciation is right, and the fluency is right, even the words that I use is right. But if the listeners, if the 127 listeners are not able to understand what I speak, my communication is bad. So communication does not relating to vocabulary sense or grammatical sense or even the fluency sense or whatever it is. It is completely associating with if the listeners understand what the speaker speaks, there is a good communication, right? Then what does this particular language associate? You know, in the very beginning, take up the dawn of human era, the communications were only in signs. Then it turned transformed to vocals, and language have become birth at the very last section of the civilization. But how do we associate with that? You know, if we measure communication skill at this particular juncture, we would always refer it to English. Am I right? We always refer communication as to the particular language called English. But how does it associate? That's what we are going to discuss today. And what does hold us back? You know, this question is very much important. Whatever the language you may speak, whether it be in English or Hindi or even Tamil or any other language for that matter, we speak a particular language. If we take an example of English, you know, we have been learning it since childhood, and I've started learning it in my third standard. I still remember I've started learning it in my third standard because we have learned it in Tamil medium. So in the very third standard, when I learned about A, B, C, D, it was not just an alphabet. It was associated with the letter A for apple, B for ball, something like that, you know. So far, you know, for every one of us now, the situation has got changed. Even the very first class of students, you know, they are learning English. And they are associating with the language for more than 17 years or 20 years. If a person comes to me at the age of 35, he has been experiencing that language in his life for more than 30 years, I would say. A particular person is being associated with the language for more than 30 years, but he's not unable to speak. He's able to write, he's able to read, he's even able to understand the language, but he's unable to respond. So what does really hold him back? So that's what we are going to discuss today. And how can we overcome it? All these are the things. So what am I, who am I to talk about it? How does a language, what is language and how does it associate with a particular, communication skill? And what does really hold us back and how can we overcome it? These are the agenda of this particular program. And now, if I put this question to you guys, to you participants, what are the things that are important? No, can I go back? If I give you a question like what is so much important to speak in English, to speak English or any other matter, these are the answers that people normally come across. I have told you that I've come across quite a good number of people in my life, and these are the excuses they make. You know, if I ask them, so why are you not speaking in English? These are the reasons they put forth. They would say vocabulary is not good. They'll say, sir, my family members are not highly educated, so I'm not. They did not put me into a school where it is the better environment for learning English. My grammar is not good. My body language isn't good. You know, the reading, the capacity that I have is not good. And I'm not very much focused. And I'm not having good marks. I'm not having memory skills. And all these are the things that people normally come across. And even many people used to say that their pronunciation is not good. But what is the real reason? What is the real reason why they are not learning it? Now let us come back to the question. Now I put your question and you can use the chat box. Now there is a screen in front of you. My question is very simple. Are you listening, I guess? I think my voice is clear, right, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You are clear.
My question is very simple. Which is the best choice to learn swimming? So I give you six choices. First choice is that I give you a big size of book. You know, I give you a book size. You know, it's very huge enough, like Java and medical students carry. You know, I give you a huge size of book, and second one I teach you. You know. And third thing is that you are learning it online. And fourth thing is that you are talking about it with your friends. And fifth one is that, you are learning swimming, right? Okay. First thing is that we are giving you a big size book. With the content of the book is swimming, and all kinds of swimming, all kinds of swimming is there. You know, the deep credentials of swimming also is there. And the second thing is that we are teaching you swimming inside the class. Third thing is that you're learning swimming online. Fourth is that we are discussing swimming with our friends. Fifth one is that, you know, you're sitting nearby the swimming pool and you're watching someone swimming, and through that you're learning. And sixth one is that, of course, you're watching videos. Which one is the best choice? You can use your chat box. Five, okay, you're watching. Five is, okay, many of us saying different answers. Okay, five, four, three. Nobody is saying one, but we are learning so many things from books, right? Are you all saying that the trainers are not good? Let us take an example of two. There are trainers to teach you, swimming. Okay, now let me come back. And none of this particular method and all these six examples, I'm sure that none of these examples are going to help you in swimming. Swimming, you cannot learn swimming by books. And you cannot, if I teach you, let us take an example that, I'm your trainer for swimming, and I've been training you for 45 days. And for 10 days, and I call the resource persons, you know, the people who have achieved a lot in swimming. And I call them and I ask them, to give you lectures, and you get so much of in-depth details about swimming from them, and you're learning through online, you're learning in different learning avenues, but none of the avenues are going to be helpful unless you put yourself into the shoes of practice. Am I right? Yes. If at all there is a practice, nothing can be learned. So language is similar to swimming. You know, if you learn from books, what we think English or language is that language, we might have come across many movies that language is, English is just a language, not a knowledge. Now, my question is, what is the significant difference between a language and a knowledge? This is the significant difference. You know, knowledge is something that we can learn out of books, through trainers, through discussion, through observation. All these six examples are the examples how you can acquire knowledge. You can learn it from books, you can learn it from reading, and you can learn it from watching, you can learn it from discussing, and you can learn it from observation itself. If I'm completely blind about politics, if there are three persons talking about all politics, and if I'm there for just half an hour, I'll get so much of intakes, right? So much of profound insights of politics. But I'm very sure that if at all, if I want to acquire knowledge, these six options will definitely help me out. But if I want to acquire skill, or which means in presence of, in another sense, if it is language, all six things will not be effective at all. You know, think about the practices that we make in our life to speak English. First one, we would go through spoken English books, right? The first one, it indicates that we will go through spoken English books, dictionaries. Second thing is that we'll go to spoken English classes. We'll spend a lot of money in it. We'll go to that. And third thing is that we will browse so much of things online. All PDFs and PPTs, video contents and all that. Fourth thing is a little effective. You can discuss with your friends. Of course, it is a little bit effective. But I'm not sure that if I go to a bilingual, we'll talk to our friends, but not in English. We'll talk about it in Tamil. That's the biggest mistake that we make. fifth thing is that if someone watches speaks English, we'll watch it so curiously, but we'll not practice it. We'll not imitate it. And the sixth thing is that, of course, we'll sit a lot of time in front of computer or technology. So swimming is a skill similar to it. Language is a skill. Language cannot be learnt out of these six examples. And the seventh option I've given is practices. That is the only medium through which you can learn a language. So language, it just requires practice. Okay, now let us come back to the language myths. Now today we are going to see the language myth as well. If people say that, now I told you that very clearly in the very previous slide, you know, if we ask people, there are so many excuses they make. Out of those excuses, I have taken only four excuses, and I'm going to prove that these are not true enough. Now, seriously, if you have so much of vocabulary, you can talk English. If you have good grammar sense, you can talk English. If you are fluent enough, if your pronunciation is good, you can talk English. All these are myths. That's what I'm trying to prove you, that it is all these are myths, and it's not right to go ahead with. For academicians like us, we should know that these are, these basics before we continue to talk in English. The first myth is that we need to have a lot of vocabulary. We need to train ourselves, and we need to mark dictionary up, and we need to go ahead with that. It's completely a myth. For example, I've given you a small kind of calculation here, but this calculation you can adjust it. You can take a piece of paper and you can do it on your own. First thing, vocabulary. I tell you, vocabulary is not at all required. Is not at all required in the sense it is required, but it is not to the level as you expect. My question is very simple. First thing is that how much of words that do we need to have to talk in English? Second thing is that how much of words do we need to talk in English fluently? These questions are slightly different. First question, how much words do we need to talk in English? You can use your chat box. I think, you know, in virtual platform, we cannot have that much of, intimate interactions. But then use your chat box. How much words do you really think that that we need to talk in English completely? My question to the participants is, how many words that we need to learn to speak English fluently? There is no limit. Okay, 3,000. I'll read out your comments. Okay, simple knowledge is required. At times it requires. I'm just asking you in numbers, please. Approximately, how much words that we need to have? 500? Yes, Anamika, right, you're nearly there. Madam Anamika, you're nearly there. Since there is a word cut, the 1,000, since there is a count like 1,476, someone is mentioning it, it's not right. 200, 1,000, 500, 2,000. Okay, you can take an example of it and you can ask English professors, you can browse through net. And if you want to speak in English, I'm sure that if you know 600 to 800 words, if you have 600 to 800 words, we can definitely speak English. Seriously, I'm not joking. But think about the situation. If you close down your eyes and if you look around your room, and if you open up your eyes, I'm sure that all the objects that are surrounded us, we'll talk that in English. We'll never say kadavu, jannal, alaipesi, tholaipesi, madikkanini, ibdiyala nama yaarume pesaradilla. All the words that we use in day-to-day life, whatever the words, whatever the names of the objects that we use are in English. So, you know, I made a small calculation here. How many words do we really know? Okay, and the second question, to answer the second question, how much of words do we need to talk in English fluently? That's the only word added into the second question. Fluently, I want to talk fluently. I want to talk in a standard English. Okay, I should not stammer anywhere. I should not struggle anywhere. Now, how many words do I really need to know to talk fluently? The second question is very simple. 100, 780. Okay, you're nearly there again. And it is double the amount of the count that I said. It needs 1,400 to 1,500 or 1,600. And I'm not joking. This is not the count that I've taken. These are the counts that I'm giving you out of the researches that people have carried out. all over the world, these are the kinds of research that these are the interesting kinds of researches that are going around the world. And okay, I said to speak in English, we just need 600 to 800. To speak fluent English, we just need 1,400 to 1,600. How much words do we really know? Okay, first one, we started with 26 alphabets, right? As I said before, when I started learning English in the third standard, only the alphabets were not given. Alphabets associated with the words were given. You know, A for apple, B for ball, like that, it was given. You know, so we started with 26 words. So we knew 26 words. And of course, you know, those words we learned, correlating that with the picture. So we knew it very clearly. And first standard to fifth standard, approximately if a student learns 50 words per year, okay, it is very, very less. Now, the count that I'm giving you is just, below the par, I would say. If we learn 1 to 5th standard, if we learn just 50 words per year, it would come about 250. In high school, if we learn 100 per year, you know, it comes to 500. You know, all together, out of environment, we learn a lot of things, you know. After using mobile phone, we learn a lot of words. Text, calls, ping up, ring up, and all these words, hold on, hang up. All these are the words that we learned when we started using mobile phones. So environment teaches us, you know. So through environment, we may learn, you know, I'm giving you very, very less count. You know, if you can take a count of on your own, you can take it. You know, I'm sure that if you take the counts on your own, I'm sure that it will go more than 3,000 words. And if you have learned undergraduation and post-graduation, you know, all of you, many of you are teachers and the student teachers. So you might definitely be undergoing through, you might have completed UG or PG. So in that, we all the English that we learn is technical English and the English which are associated with the core competence of our program. Now with the core of our, the program that we learn. So if we learn 300, so on to altogether we have learned 1,476, and these are the very lesser counts. Okay. Now my question is very simple. How many words do we really need to know to talk in English? It is just 600 to 800. But the words that we know is double the amount of, not even double, it is nearly the triple the amount. Okay. And how much of words do we need to talk in English? And these count is nearly parallel to the count that I mentioned, it is 1,400 to 1,600. Then my question is, why we are unable to talk in English? Okay, we have enough vocabulary, then why we are unable to talk about it? That's what we are going to discuss. And let it be kept confidential till the time the slide comes in. And another question I want to raise, if I am put in Mumbai, let us assume that I do not know Hindi at all. Okay, I do not know how to read Hindi, I do not know how to write Hindi, and even when someone speaks in Hindi, I'm unable to understand, you know. I'm completely I'm unexposed to the language of Hindi. I'm put in Mumbai. I'm working there for 3 months, okay, 3 months for a year and all that. People, whoever is around, they're talking in Hindi, they do not know Tamil, they do not know English. So my question is, how much time would it take for me to learn Hindi or to speak Hindi? Again, you can use your chat box, and don't think that I'm gonna keep on lapping up so many questions to you, but if at all I ask you a question, I think you'd fall asleep. I think 10 days, few months, only the people who have given come in before, they are only giving. What about the new people? 2 months, 1 month, maybe a month, few months. Okay, thank you. And my another question, I want to put it on that. Okay. Within a month, 1 month, 3 months. Okay. Many of the participants, I do not know about the participants, but I'm sure that nearly 50% of the participants will be that in the criteria. Okay. Many of us, Mike, if I'm put in Mumbai, I'm learning a language in which I'm not exposed at all. I'm learning it within few months, 2 months, 1 month, even some of you are saying few days, right? The language in which I'm not at all exposed, I'm learning it in just 30 days. Let us assume that 30 days, okay? I'm learning it in 30 days. But in the other language, let us take an example of English. I know how to read. I know how to write it. I know, I understand that very clearly. But then why I'm not able to speak it, right? Why I'm unable to speak it? Because I have this kind of myth. The myth is vocabulary. We think that vocabulary is very much important to speak English. It is not at all. If you think that it is vocabulary, it is because of vocabulary. You have enough vocabulary. That's what I wanted to prove. It requires only 600 to 700, 600 to 800 to speak English. But then we have more than the ample amount that we require to speak English. And these are more than, more than the demand that we have. But then, okay. So vocabulary is not needed. You know, it is, you have that vocabulary with you. You don't need to practice it too much. You don't need to, look up dictionary very often. We have, right? Then, what is the other myth that we have? So this is one of the myth that we have. And now let us go back to the thing that what does really hold us back, right? In the very thing that I told you, who am I to talk about it? Because I've got quite a good number of people. And now, second thing is that how does language associate with communication? Okay, so language is a skill. Language is a skill. We say communication is also a skill. For example, I would tell you, if a student is learning five different languages for five different subjects in 10th standard, for example, Tamil, English, Tamil, English, Maths, Science, and Social Science. Okay. If English teacher is good enough in fluency, we would say that the communication skill of the teacher is good. Communication skill. We would always refer those words. Skill. English is a skill. I mean, language is a skill. Right? When you speak language good, it means that you have communication skill. But if the science teacher is good enough, if the equation is very wrong in the book, some of the science teachers and some of the maths teachers will find errors in the books. Okay, they'll dictate students that in the page there is a wrong answer. The answer is wrong. The step is wrong. That you can correct it. And these are the teachers. They have sound knowledge in subject called maths. Now, why one teacher is good in one subject, that teacher is called as she is or he is good in communication skill. We refer that person as a skillful person. If another teacher in she or he is good in science or social science, we would say that the person is good, having good knowledge in the subject. One subject is termed as skill and the other subject is termed as knowledge, because English is a language. Language is always associated with skill. But science and social science are the things that you can learn through these six examples. Science you can learn from books. You can learn from books. You can learn from the discussion. You can learn from any other things, because this is purely a knowledge. And the teacher has acquired that kind of knowledge through reading a lot of books, attending many webinars, attending many classes, and discussing it with learning it online. She has or he has developed a lot of things through learning, So that is kind of knowledge. So how does it associate with that? Because it is a skill and the other part is the knowledge. But what are we developing as in terms of English? What are we actually developing? We are developing knowledge, not a skill. If you are doing any of the things in the six options, if any of the thing, out of this, if you do any of the thing out of six, I'm sure that you are only acquiring knowledge, not a skill. But to speak English, you just only need a skill, not a knowledge, right? So only you need a practice. So okay, now let us come back to that. What are the things that hold us back? Barrier number five. Let us come back from the bottom to top, right? So what is the fifth barrier that we have? Okay, it is poor listening skill. The biggest communication problem arises is not because, okay, it is not because of any other factor, but it is only because we don't give our ears to listen very clearly. Right now, let us shall we all test our listening skill? In this webinar, I have 30 more minutes. Shall we all test our listening skill with a small practice? Okay, now I'll play an audio. Is it audible?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Sir, actually, you need to open this file at the background.
Oh, no, it normally works.
So far, we have did that procedure, sir. That's why. Just give a try.
Little,
It's not working. Then, okay, let's skip it up. Normally, what I do is that I'll tell you what I do. Okay, so what normally I
Some
do is
sound is
that
coming.
I.
Yeah, sorry,
Some
please
sound is
try, sir.
coming. Yes.
Shall I play once again?
Ah, yes, sir.
I think it's not audible.
Yes, yes, sir, it is coming. Some sound is coming.
No, it's not the one. In the background, someone has unmuted themselves, I guess. Okay, so I'll skip it up. Now I'll share the slide with you. If possible, you open it up, okay, and you test your listening skill. All that it says is that if you play this particular button, there will be an audio playing in the background. Okay, let me. Shall I try one more time? 1 minute. Give me just 1 minute, ma'am. Not just 1 minute, just 10 seconds. Okay, now I think you'll be able to hear that sound. No?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, it's not playing. I'm very sorry to the technical difficulty. But if it's playing, there will be two people talking in the background. One is A and the other one is B. They'll be talking and their accent is very, you know, similar to the native accent. They'll be talking a little bit fast. You know, in the very beginning, I'll play that particular audio and I'll ask the students to listen to that. They'll say, yes, we're all listening it, sir. It's very easy to understand, though they are talking in the natural accent and the native accent. We are able to listen it very completely and we are able to understand it all. So that's the response from the students that I normally get. And after, once again, I play the play another audio showing a different content. And again, I'm sure that they'll be able to grasp the things that they listen in the audio. Okay. I think the other person has started sharing the screen. Is it so?
No, sir, your screen is visible.
Okay. Right. Third thing is that, you know, I'll ask
sir.
Some of the question, you know, and the third
Excuse
thing,
me,
I'll play another audio, the third audio, but there won't be any subtitles.
Excuse
These
me,
are
sir.
The subtitles, right? Once I play the audio, right, they'll be listening it very curiously, but at the
Excuse
same
me.
Time, the subtitles will be there, right? But when I don't give the subtitles, when I ask them only to listen.
Excuse me, sir, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
sir. Start presenting again, sir, because in the record, your slides will not be visible. That's why.
Okay. Now, again, I tell you.
Yeah. Thank you so much, sir.
No problem, ma'am. Okay. So, when I give them the first slide, I'll give the audio and the subtitles. And these are the subtitles. And they'll be able to understand. Even when I give them the second, they'll be able to understand. Because I'll give them the subtitles and I'll give them the audio as well. In the third thing, I'll cut off only one thing, you know. I'll play only the audio, not the subtitles. With the same accent, with the same speed, with the same persons talking, but different content. Okay, I'll ask only four questions out of it. Because if it plays, I can show you how it works. But it's not playing, unfortunately. Even in the same system I'm using, where I made it up. Okay. Okay, unfortunately, I'm unable to play it, but then I'll share the slide with you. So if it plays with you, you can make use of it. Okay, listen to that audio and based on the audio, there will be four questions asked. But many of the students will say that they are not able to understand. And now
Excuse
I pose
me, sir,
another
can you
question.
Hear me? Sir, can you
yes,
hear me?
Madam. Yes, madam.
Sir, please stop presenting and you again start presenting, sir, because somebody presented in between. So we could see your face now, but not the slides.
Shall I close it once again and stop
yes,
sharing?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So So if suppose if you come across any other presentation, you please stop presenting and start to present again, sir.
Okay, madam, no problem.
Yeah, because in the record we won't have the presentation if other than you anybody else starts presenting, sir.
Okay, madam. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Is it okay now?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. If I give them only the audio, and based on the audio, if I ask them some question, I'm sure that they'll not be able to answer, just because they do not give their ears to understand what is it. Instead, they start reading it. Since we are able to read English, they are just only reading without giving their ears to the language. What normally we do is that people keep saying that if you watch English movies, you'll be able to speak English. Yes, it is true. Seriously, it is true. But why it is not working with us? Why we are unable to talk English even after watching thousands and thousands of movies? But it is simple, because we watch it with subtitles. We read instead of listening. We just read. Without reading, of course, without reading, we cannot understand anything. But then if you give your ears completely, and that accent will be very familiar with you, and you'll be acquiring that accent knowledge with you now without the now conscious mind, you'll start acquiring the accent stuff with you. So what normally people is that they read subtitles and they watch movies, and even after watching hundreds of movies, they'll not be able to replicate it, or they'll not be able to respond it the same way that they have learned. Okay, so what we have to do is that we have to listen a lot. And I thought of giving you an exercise, but it doesn't work at now. It's not working now, so that I'm unable to give. I think let me try if this works. No, even if it's not working. Okay, let me skip it up due to the time constraint. Okay, so listen to it. Whenever someone speaks English, listen to it. Whenever you watch movie, take off the subtitles. Please do not watch it with subtitles, because what you normally do is that with subtitles, you only read without giving your ears to the content. So please do not watch it with subtitles. Now for the very 20 minutes, for 15 minutes to 20 minutes, you'll not be able to understand anything, because their accent is completely different. And now after 20 minutes, there will be something, only 10% or 20% will be understandable. And if the process is keep on going, I'm sure after 3 movies or 4 movies, we'll be able to understand very completely, even without subtitles. That's the practice that you have to give it to your mind. And this barrier number 4, why we are not able to speak English in the academic English. Okay, the barrier number 4 is we have translation process in our mind. Okay, all majority of the Tamil medium people, they used to say me this, before they speak English, their mind process. Now, in the background, it processes. If I want to tell you, hi, Kingston, எப்படி இருக்கீங்க அப்படி நான் கேட்கணும்னா, மைண்டில் எப்படி கிங்ஸ்டன், ஹாய், how are you, these are the things normally come into your mind. நாங்கள் வந்தப்போவன் இல்லையே அப்படின்னு சொல்வதாக இருந்தால், they'll take everything into your mind, First, they think in Tamil and they reproduce it in English. This translation process spoils your fluency. If you want to speak in English, you have to think in English. The translation process will not be very much effective at all. It won't be at all effective. If the translation process goes into your mind, I'm very sure that you will fail in fluency. Even if you try for years, and you'll not be able to speak it very fluently. So how can I train that? How can I overcome it? If I want to break this barrier, yes, sir, this is the only thing. இது ரொம்ப ஈஸியாக கண்டுபிடிக்கலாம். இஃப் ஐ கோ பைலிங்கில் ஐ டெல் யூ, இஃப் தே ஸ்பீக் இங்கிலீஷ் அட் பர்டிகுலர் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் டைம் தேல் ஸ்டாப் சம்வேர் அண்ட் லாஸ் இதுக்கு தமிழில் என்ன, இதுக்கு இங்கிலீஷில் என்ன, அண்ட் இந்த கிராமரில் இது எப்படி சொல்கிறது, தேல் ஸ்டாப் இன் பிட்வீன் அண்ட் அட் அ பர்டிகுலர் பாயிண்ட் தேல் ஆஸ் தி அதர் பர்சன் வாட் இஸ் இட் கால்ட் இன் இங்கிலீஷ். ஸோ தட் இஸ் தி இண்டிகேட்டர் தட் டெல்ஸ் யூ தட் த ட்ரான்ஸ்லேஷன் ப்ராசஸ் இஸ் தேர் இன் யோர் மைண்ட். யோர் மைண்ட் கோஸ் சர்டன் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ட்ரான்ஸ்லேஷன் ப்ராசஸ். If it goes, you'll not be able to speak English. I'm very sure. Okay? I'm damn sure that if it is there, and adha kandupidikkiradhu innum rendu moonu valigal irukku. Udharanama, they'll stop in between and they'll ask you what is it called in English or what is it called in other language. One. And the second thing, the all the things will be coming into. I went there these all and all these rhythmic things and all, right? These things will appear. So these things, the revisiting the errors will be the third indicator. these three indicators will tell you that your mind processes in the background. If it processes in the background, it means that you're thinking in a different language and you are reproducing it in another language. You're thinking in Tamil and you're producing it in English, I'm sure that it would definitely spoil the fluency. So make sure that you're not doing this kind of activity. You know, if it is there in your mind, I'm sure that your English won't be, your not English, any language that you speak won't be good enough. Okay, don't mix two or three languages when you speak. Speak in one language and the same language you have to think. Make up your mind to think in the same language in which you're going to speak, in which you're going to deliver. All right. So how can I test, sir? How can I improve that? How can I take out, you know, remove the translation process from my mind? It is very easy. This is the process that I want to put forth. Jumbled IQ test. And this is the one of the tests that I give my students when they appear in the very beginning. We can understand a lot of things from giving this example. You know, if I take a word of communication, if I take this word communication, I jumble these letters anywhere I want, I can take it up. Now you can jumble, scramble, you know, we get the word scrambling and jumbling letters and all, whatever the word that you can take. But this is the test that we normally call jumbled IQ test. I have broken that particular word into a lot of pieces, okay, by shuffling the letters of the word called communication, out of which I have taken common, nation, onion, you know, these are the letters that we take, ton and cat, mat, notion, and you have to take the letters which have certain meaning. You know, all these words have certain meaning. There are rules. First rule, you have to talk in English little fast. You have to talk in English little fast. Please do not practice very slow in the beginning, because if you practice very slow, the translation process will always be there. So make sure that you are talking little bit fast. Okay. Second thing is that create a story using the words chronologically. Chronologically means top to bottom, common, nation, onion, ton, cat, mat, notion, motion, and all. In this criteria, you can talk. Okay. First thing, you have to arrange the words which carry certain meaning. Second thing is that create a story, cook up a story. Okay, as someone is saying that union, of course, if I missed that, you can add it on, right? Create a story using these letters chronologically, common to nation. For example, if I tell you a story, I tell you a story using the letter, not story, anything else, right? There is a common notion in the nation that if the onion prices goes, you know, it surges, I'm sure that ton of onions will be kept in to create an artificial demand. And these are the story that I create using the first four words that I've given. So there is a common tendency in our nation, if the onion prices goes up and the tons and tons of onions kept idle, you know, kept in a secret place to create an artificial demand. This is the thing. Okay. So one of the cat entered into the godown where the onions were kept. So these are the ways in which you can cook up your story. Not necessarily the story should be good. Not necessarily the story should have any correlation or connection with the previous word. You can go ahead anywhere, any way that you want to. You want to go ahead. So jumbling the word, you have to create a story, then talk not less than 3 minutes. You have to talk not less than 3 minutes. Okay, talk fast. That's the important thing. That's the important thing. And all the three last, you know, in the last three things, I've given three important rules, right? 3 minutes, talk fast, and don't stretch and pause. If you think there is a common, if you stretch or if you give any pause, if you stop anywhere, start from the beginning. Now, even if you might have come to the last word, noon or moon, but then you somewhere in the beginning, somewhere in the last, you know, somewhere in the flow, if you had struggled a bit, you know, if you stopped or if you stretched, make sure that you stop then and there and start from the beginning, right? You should be very fast. You should not talk less than 3 minutes, and you should not stretch or you should not pause. If you practice this for any word that you learn, if you practice this for just 1 week, and that translation process will go out of your mind. Your mind will start thinking in English, you know, start thinking in English. And the third barrier, we're all adults, right? We're all adults. You're very happy about it. Okay. We learned a lot of things, you know, we have degree behind our names, and we are working as teachers. We are student teachers. So we have got more than 18 years of age. So we all have that adult mind in our, you know, we have that adult mind, you know, that's very bad to speak English. You know, that's very bad to speak any language, you know, that will always put hindrances. That will be always a scotch when you want to go ahead and ahead in your life, that will always be a scotch in terms of language only, I'm saying, not in the other thing. Okay, in terms of language, if you have your adult mind within you, I'm very sure that you'll not be able to speak. So what is that adult mind, sir? Adult mind will always think these things. So why? You know, what if I say, if a student asks me, sir, is there any other ways to ask how are you? One student asked me, this is a real example. One student asked me when I was in when the year 2015, I think 2016, the very beginning, he asked me, sir, எப்படி இருக்கீங்கன்னு கேக்குறது, we are all using how are you. Is there any other ways in which we can ask the same question? I said, yes. Formally, you can ask like this. Informally, you can ask this. Well, one of the examples, I said, how do you do? How do you do? He split it up. He said, how, எப்படி, do, செய்யற. எப்படி செய்யறன்னு தானே சார் அர்த்தம் வரும். இது ஏன் நம்ம do உள்ளதுக்கு போடுறோம்? This is what I really term as adult mind. These adult mind won't help you at all. No? It'll always ask you why and how. Why not like this? Why like this and why not like that? So now you'll ask so many questions like this. If you keep the adult mind within you, I'm sure that you'll not be able to speak. Speak like a kid or speak like a drunk. These two people will not have anything in their mind. Okay, first choice is the better choice that I would always give. If you prefer to be the second one, even I'm very happy about it. Because drunk will fast very faster than a kid. So if the second choice is yours, I'm sure that you'll be able to speak much faster than a kid. Okay. Solution is, making mistake is the best way to learn any language. Any language. You know, without making mistake, you cannot learn anything. If at all you fall down, when you learn bicycle, you'll not be able to ride bicycle. If you want to ride bicycle, you have to fall. At cases, if you don't fall, I'm very sure that the learning that you get out of it won't be very effective enough. Right, that's the thing that we have. And the third barrier, and we put a lot of barriers, but these are not, you know, real barriers. The third barrier is that please kill the adult in you. Okay, in terms of language only, I'm saying, but when you talk to others, make sure that the kid dies and the adult is alive. Okay, if the kid is everywhere, and I'm very sure that you'll find a mess up in your life. Okay, so don't follow my advices any other than language, other than English. If you carry the kid mind when you get along with people, I'm sure that you'd be thrown out of the market. Okay, and that's one of the advice that I want to give. Right, barrier number three is an adult mind. Don't have an adult mind in you. Don't ask questions. That inquisitiveness will always kill you. Okay, have that inquisitiveness, but don't ask too much of questions. Okay, posting too much of questions, you'll end up nowhere. Okay, if you want to be very successful in speaking a language, make sure that you kill the adult in yourself in terms of language. Speak like a kid or speak like a drunk. Either the way, you can improve your language. What's the second barrier? Okay, gulping it down. Okay, let me quickly finish it off. Gulping it down is one of the biggest barriers that I have come across. And I'm giving you these barriers not from books. You cannot learn any these barriers from anywhere. No, out of the experiences that I've learned, by getting along with people, by training them, by giving some practices to them, by giving activity-based learnings, and I've learned it. Okay, even if you listen to my English, there would be some mistakes, but I'm not worried about. I'm not at all worried. But I know that I'm making mistakes. In the next webinar, I'll take it out. You know, I'll correct my mistakes because I know that I'm making a mistake. You know, I'm sure that when I was talking, I made three or four mistakes. I knew that I was making, but that enough. You know. No, I don't need to revisit to my mistake and make a clear obvious that the audience can understand, oh, this guy made a mistake. No, not like that. Okay, third, let us come back to the second barrier, that is gulping it down. Let me give you an example. If I give you an activity to tell you, sir, what are the things that you normally do in your days? Routine, in a routine life, what are the things that you're normally doing, right? For example, I used to give this activity to my students. To train them to speak present tense. For example, sir, காலையில 6 மணிக்கு எந்திரச்சதுல இருந்து நைட் பெட்டுக்கு போற வரைக்கும் என்னென்னலாம் பண்றீங்க? What are the normal routines that you have? Okay, from 6 am to night 10 am 10 pm. So he'll say தமிழ்ல முதல்ல கேப்பேன். I'll ask them to speak in Tamil. They'll say காலையில எந்திப்பனா எந்திக்க மனசு இல்லாம எந்திப்பேன், அப்படியே உருண்டுட்டே வருவேன், எங்க அம்மா வேற வந்து எழுப்பிக்கிட்டே இருப்பாங்க. அப்புறமா அலாரம் வேற ஒரு கரெக்டில் அடிச்சுட்டே இருக்கும், நான் ஸ்னூஸ் பண்ணிகிட்டே இருப்பேன். போர் அடிக்கும் காலேஜ் டைம்னா இல்லை ஆஃபீஸ் டைம்னா அறிவுரையில் எழுந்திரிச்சு ஓடணும். தேல் கிவ் அப் யூனோ, தேல் மேக் அ ஸ்டோரி யூனோ, ஈவன் இஃப் யூ கிவ் தெம் 10 மினிட்ஸ் இட் வோன்ட் பி எனாஃப் ஃபார் தெம் டு டிஸ்கிரைப் வாட் ஆர் தே நார்மலி டூ யூனோ. ஈவன் த மேட் ஆஃப் 5th மினிட் அண்ட் தேல் பி ஒன்லி தேல் பி டாக்கிங் அபவுட் த பெட் ஸ்டோரிஸ், நாட் ஈவன் தி ஆஃபீஸ் ஸ்டோரிஸ். தே வுட் ஹவ் நாட் ஈவன் லேண்டட் அப் ஆன் தி ஆஃபீஸ் ஓகே, பட் தேல் பி டாக்கிங் சோ மச் ஆஃப் திங்ஸ் யூசிங் சோ மெனி திங்ஸ் யூனோ. பட் I'll ask them to translate that in English. They'll treat me as their PA. No, PA only has to, you know, need to note down the times that they are, what do they do at different times. They'll treat me like their personal assistant. They'll tell you, sir, I'll wake up at 6 a.m., sir. Okay. I'll brush my teeth at 6:30 p.m., 6:30 a.m., sir. I'll take my breakfast at 8 o'clock, sir. I'll reach my office at 10 o'clock, sir. In just 30 seconds, they'll finish everything. But in Tamil, they'll cook up stories like it would extend more than 10 minutes. But what has happened? They gulp it down, you know, they gulp it down. They filter everything because they do not know. You make a note of whatever the things that you do not know, and you should ask the person who knows it, right? Be it anyone, you know. So the one of the best example I've given, the English inside my mind is like a Ferrari. But what I speak out is like an auto, right? So what about the value that these two vehicles have? Okay, the first one is having something predominant, you know, predominantly high. The second one is, if I have, sir, I slug on my bed for some time until my mom nags at me to wake up, I'll turn around, I'll just snuggle, sir, no, I'll waste a lot of time, I'll snooze my, this is what the things that I want to say. But what I say? Sir, I wake up at 6:30 a.m., sir. So this is the English that I speak. If you have this practice, I'm sure that you would limit yourself from learning new things. Don't limit yourself. Limiting yourself in terms of learning new things. Okay, so you're here, you're losing an opportunity to learn. Sir, urundite varadhukku enna? Endichittu mobile snooze pannite irukkuradhukku enna? Adha eppadi solradhu? You're losing an opportunity to learn new things. So that's the way that you have to look at it. Okay, so make sure that if something is not, you know, very clear, if you're unable to say how to speak it, please make sure that you have an assistance, which means you have an assist, have an assistant, not assistant, have a friend to clear your doubts then and there. And this is one of the biggest barrier. That's why I've given it, given the number two. The first barrier is a psychological barrier. Altogether, I put it in just one word called psychological barrier. First one, lack of confidence. Sir, the one of the lame excuses people make is, I'm from Tamil medium. When I hear this excuse, I'm sure that I'll get angry. Seriously, I get angry because they've been connected with the language for more than 17 years. Okay. And at this particular juncture, they've been, the very first day they land up in school, they start learning English only, not even Tamil. Okay, they give so many excuses. First excuse is that they always say Tamil medium. Even in the second example, if they've learned an English medium, they would say ange Tamil la sir edupanga, ange ullavangalukku English theriyadhu sir. That's the second thing that they make. Okay, so that the second factor is that fear of making mistakes. If at all you make mistake, you'll not be able to speak. I'm running through it very quickly because we are running short of time, so kindly bear with me. Fear of making mistake is one of the thing that, you know, we always put the blame on others, that they'll laugh at me, sir, they'll criticize me, they'll make fun of me. What is your problem? You are going to learn something, you know, you're learning an additional language. Sir, I know a language. The basic need of a man is to know a language to communicate with the people. I know it. I know Tamil. You know, if I want to be alive for the rest of the years, Tamil is enough for me. So why do I learn English? Is, you know, settle down in a job or to earn money or to communicate with the wide range of people. That's the need that I have to learn another language. So learning another language is an additional benefit of us. You should not be ashamed of it. You should be very proud. Even if you are making mistake, you should be very proud that you are making another language. You are learning another language. You are taking another step to acquire another skill from a different dimension. So you have to be very proud when you make mistake, not to be shameful of it. Okay. And the third thing is that thinking of others, and that's the, you know, I can connect with that in the previous thing as well. Language myths, as we said before, vocabulary is needed to not to the level. Pronunciation is needed not to the to the level as you expect. Okay, pronunciation in English it is not at all required. That's what I would always say. If you have listened, if you had a chance to listen to the North Indian English, they won't say it's my mobile. They would say it is my mobile. It is my mobile. They would they won't pronounce is. They would say age. So even people understand, right? I know South Indian English differ from even in South Indian, Keralites English differ. They would say October, but we say October. Okay, there are so many differences. There are so many differences. Okay, language myths are there. Pronunciation is needed, vocabulary is needed, grammar is needed, and all those things are myths of language. Don't fall for it. Okay, blaming environment. Don't put the blame on others. Instead, blame yourself. Okay, if you think that others are laughing, it means that you're considering others instead of considering yourself. If you're thinking your betterment, you won't be worried about it at all. Okay, so don't blame the environment and settling down in a comfort zone. And enough with that. Okay, so there are many, I'm sorry to say this, many academicians like this are there. You know, they would settle down in a job, they won't learn anything new. They would say, this is enough to carry out the, this is enough for me. To roll over the years that I have. No, that's the bad attitude that we have. If you are in a comfort zone, I'm sure that you would not be able to learn anything, not at all language, anything you won't be able to learn. Don't settle down in comfort zone. It would definitely kill you, right? And these are the factors. All together, I would put it in like, if I put it in a single phrase, I would say, single term, I would say psychological barriers. And these are the barriers. And even when I started the barrier, people said me that, fear, sir, fear, confidence, sir. And if you put it all together, I would say psychological barrier. Your mental soundness is not good enough to learn a language. You have to have a sound mental ability before you proceed to learn anything, not just language. If you want to learn a new thing, your mental soundness is the first preparation that you have to have, the mental preparedness. If you have that, I'm sure that you can speak any language, not just English. Okay, these are the barriers and, to develop the solution is that develop a better self-image, talk in front of mirror. Talking in front of mirror will definitely give you a good hike and that would definitely help you in reaping the quantum leap of your life in terms of English. Okay, and talk, record and review. People quite often do it when they learn singing. When they sing loud using headphones and later they record it, they hear it and they improvise. And this method will definitely help you in learning a language as well. Keep a record. When you speak, record it and after you listen to it you'll find out some mistakes and you can improve your language and these are the ways in which you can improve. Okay, again I come back from the first one. Fifth one, poor listening skill. Give your ears first, that's the solution. The mind next. Give your ears first, the mind next. The mind will follow you. Okay, if you listen completely you'll be able to imitate. Try to imitate people. No, if you're coming across a person who's good in English, now try to imitate like them. Use the words they have already used. No problem in it. You know, imitating the sense of imitation that you have, you know, about other people's in terms of English, I'm sure that kind of imitation will lead you to a different style, right? So first one, the solution is that give your ears first. Second problem, the fourth problem. No, it's not moving. It's stuck. Okay. Fourth problem is the translation error. To think fast, you know, to train your mind to think in English, I've given you the jumbled IQ test. This test will definitely be helpful. So make sure that you are following this test. And for this particular test, use a bigger word like communication, information, like that word which has more than 10 characters, right? Adult mind, kill your adult mind, okay? The solution is that, as I said before, bring in a kid in you, okay? So, or bring in a drunk in you, okay? So these are the two things. So now make yourself, think yourself as a kid or think yourself as a drunk, right? The second is the best choice that I would always prefer because that person doesn't think anything, right? The second problem is that barrier. Number two is that gulping it down or filtering. Don't filter anything. If you're unable to speak what is there in your mind, please make a note of it, write it in Tamil and ask the person who is well-versed in it. And the last barrier, there is no biggest barrier than this. There is no biggest barrier than this. This is the biggest of all. And develop a better self-image, have your positive mind before you start speaking. Don't think about others and have a better self-image and record, review it. Okay, you are the best master for yourself, and don't depend on anything too much on others. If you have a positive self-image on you, I'm sure that this will definitely help you to bring out the best communicator within you, right? Thank you so much. If at all you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you. I've completed it exactly at 12 o'clock. Thank you, organizers. Thank you, everyone, for your patient listening. And I'm so glad that the participants were quite interesting, and they were kept on giving me comments. Like, sir, whenever I asked them a question, they kept comments. I mean, they kept giving comments. It was so interesting. It made a lively, presentation. So thank you, participants. You made it very successful, because if at all there is no comment from you, I won't be motivated at all. Thank you once again. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your fantabulous presentation. There is a saying, good communication is the bridge between confusion and clarity. You made us to travel through the bridge, removed our confusion, and gave a transparency, clearness with your experience, ideas, and activities. Thank you so much, sir. And in the participants, there is a...
If there is any question, you can ask. If there is any time, I think you have another session in the next couple of minutes, right? I think there is no questions from the participants end.
Sir, one more question, sir.
Yes, madam.
Secondary, how many minutes are there per day to spend in practice with English for best communication?
Minimum it is required 30 minutes to 1 hour, ma'am. Minimum it requires 30 minutes to 1 hour. Minimum. And you don't need to spare any special time for it. Whenever people come and talk to you in a regional language like Tamil, okay, you can bring it to your mind that இதை இங்கிலீஷில் சொல்கிறதா இருந்தால் எப்படி சொல்லியிருக்கலாம், ஒருவேளை அதை எப்படி போட்டிருந்தால் நல்லா இருக்கும் அப்படிங்கிறத கூட நீங்கள் பேசி பார்க்கலாம். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், மெனி இன்சிடென்சஸ் யூ கேன் கிவ். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், இஃப் யூ ஆர் இன்வைட்டட் டு த ஸ்கூல் தட் யூ ஹேட் ஸ்டடிட் ஆஸ் அ ரிசோர்ஸ் பர்சன் ஆர் ஆஸ் அ கெஸ்ட் சீஃப் கெஸ்ட், ஹவு யூ வுட் டாக். ஸோ ஹாவ் சர்டன் கைண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஒரு எப்படி சொல்கிறது அது கரெக்டாக சர்டன் கைண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் சிச்சுவேஷன் இன் யுவர் மைண்ட் அண்ட் கோ பை இட், ப்ராக்டிஸ் இட் ஃபார் ஜஸ்ட் 30 minutes in a day will be definitely helpful. Less than 30 minutes won't be helpful, man. It will be helpful anyway, but it take lot of time. It requires at least 30 minutes to 1 hour.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your explanation. Thank you, Vinolia ma'am, for asking the question. I had a little network issue. Thank you so much, ma'am. Now we have come to the valedictory program. As all good things, yes.
Organizer, sorry for the interruption. Dr. Rasul,
yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Rasul sir, please take your own time, sir.
Not own time, only a few minutes with the Kingston sir. Kingston sir, I am Dr. Rasul, yes, working as an English lecturer in VOC College of Education. In fact,
sir.
I also
used you, sir? To
fine. I have already heard
a lot about you, sir.
Right, I also hear a lot about you. The first time I think we are meeting. I have attended some of your sessions also. My children are your student, of course. But what I want to emphasize here, I also used to take classes previously, emphasizing how to develop cognitive fluency skill. And your class is entirely different. Within the short span of time, you impressed everybody and you made everybody work. Of course, I belong to the older generation. I am the 60 kids, you can call me. But as you told, I was in comfortable zone, but you opened my eyes. In fact, your lecture is an eye-opener, which makes me to go further. In fact, it is very nice, a very nice example, teach a very nice language, and with a lot of works, I usually, when if I have the English teachers like you during my school studies, I have been a better English speaker even before 2 decades earlier. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much for your feedback, sir. It means a lot to me.
Right. Thank you, sir. Keep the spirit.
Thank you. Sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank
so
you.
Much.
Over to the organizer. Thank you, organizer.
Okay, sir. Thank you, Russell, sir. Now we have come to the valedictory program. Yes.
Priyama.
Yes, Dava ma'am. Yes.
You can ask some participant to share their feedback with our resource person for a few minutes.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, regarding the session.
Can anyone? Yes. Participants, can you share your feedback regarding the session?
There is a man, I think Leo or something else. He enjoyed the class very much. He usually gave a comment every now and then. Can I ask that man?
Yes, sir.
Anybody, but my preference is that man. But you, Leo, Josephine or something else. He enjoyed the class like anything. Through his comment chat box, I came to understand he enjoyed the class like anything. Ask him or otherwise, some other people. There is
Hello, okay. Chitra.
The person who is talking now, another RP, I think he is Rasul sir. That class was also very interesting, and sir said some 60s and all that, but it was not at all like that. We enjoyed his class also a lot, and Mr. Kingston RP was excellent, madam. And couldn't believe that he was a student of Tamil medium. Presentation was so good. Of course, as he said, there were some mistakes in between, and what he told us, we should never be bothered about that. And
yes,
that
ma'am.
He says, I am able to find out, like I am able to take what are the mistakes in what I spoke. So that thing should be there in a teacher. And even he has taught that to us, and excellence, hats off to you. And
you,
the person who was talking, you know, the other RP who was talking about Kingston sir, he was also too good. I really wanted to thank him the other day, but couldn't. And today I got a chance. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay. And thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you for your feedback.
It was an excellent session. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Any other participant?
I'll be glad if there is any question.
Yes, welcome sir, Lijo Abraham. Welcome sir.
Hello, good afternoon everyone. My name is
Lijo Abraham.
Thank you sir. Thank you so much sir, Rasul sir. And I'm from Telangana and I hail from Kerala at the same time. And I've enjoyed the session very much, and I teach English as well. But as sir mentioned it, like I always would like to add humor to the class where I found Kingston, Mr. Kingston Jio has added a lot of humor, which only made the session very colorful. So actually, even this was a good lesson to me also as well. You know, how can I add a good part of humor in my class so that, especially when language comes, I need to do that, or else like children would feel bored and they would only be repellent. So this is actually a good strategy, Mr. Kingston Jio has used it. So I really appreciate, sir, and the session
Thank
was
you.
Really good and. And there were many things which I learned. Even I've been teaching English for last 10 years, as Rasul sir mentioned it, like every day will be a new day for learning. So the session has been very fruitful to me as well. So I thank the organizers for bringing up such good experts for the past all 5 days. And I've been with this program for all the past years, past 5 days. And thank you, sir. Thank you, Jiva sir. Thank you for the
thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your efforts. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir, for your wonderful feedback. We had our sessions for 7 days, sir.
Mail our
community. Yes, Dava ma'am. Sir Kingston, sir, there is a question in the chat box.
Okay.
At the school level, even it is insisted in a friendly, motivated manner. Some students hesitate to converse. What could be done?
This is one of the very interesting question. I thank Bharati madam, Bharati sir,
Saraswati Balaji
madam, and both
yes,
of them
sir.
For the wonderful questions. It's very easy, ma'am. You know, instead of giving them homeworks, give them activity-based learning. Okay. Ask them. You give them some letters. Ask them to dance, or ask them. To react to the letters that they've learned, you know, give them some exercises in which they enjoy and learn. And what normally I do is that, you know, for people like college students exclusively, I'll play a video. In that video, I'm sure, and if it sounds weird, forgive me. Okay, there is a video in the YouTube, which says the pronunciational error, that 100 pronunciational errors that we normally make. So I used to play a video in front. I had projected in my institution, so I used to play the video. Once I played it, they'll have certain kind of interest towards it. I stop in between. I give my own preparations in between. I stop and again I play that video once again. So this kind of interest, you know, in that video, a lady will come and she'll be very beautiful. So that they'll give the whole attention to the video at first. So I'll grasp grasp their attention at first, and then I'll push my content in the next. So this is one of the tactics that I use with teens. But for school kids, they'll enjoy if there is anything with music, associated with music, rhymes or play, something like that. If school kids, for example, how would you say that in English? If you put this kind of method to the students, they'll not be interested. Instead of saying that, where is the glass? They'll show on the table. Say that it is on the table. Now take out the glass, ask them where it was. Okay, they'll say it is in the table still. Now you can correct their English, say it was on the table. Something like that, they'll enjoy. So if there is anything associated with the activity, they'll always enjoy. For school kids, if it is anything associated with music, they'll always love to do it.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Priya ma'am, shall we start the valedictory session?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Good afternoon, sir. Warm welcome to our the most respected registrar.
Excuse me.
Teachers at University, sir. Sir, good afternoon, sir. Sir, please unmute your audio, sir.
Welcome, sir. Sir. Dava ma'am, shall I start?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
hello.
Please. Yes. Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir. I'm Dr. Lakshmi, sir.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everything
welcome,
is clear, sir. Everything is clear, sir.
Yes.
Shall we start the session, sir?
Okay.
Okay. Yes. Thank you, sir.
Now we have come to the valedictory program. As all good things come to an end in life, so is this 7-day online enrichment program on holistic development of teachers. As beginning of the valediction, I request Dr. T. Kanagaraj, Principal, VOC College of Education, to perform the welcome address. Welcome, sir. Principal, sir.
Principal, sir, is on.
Yes, madam.
Principal, sir.
Ma'am, I am audible.
Yes, sir.
I am audible.
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, madam.
Good morning, sir.
Madam, audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The most respected registrar of Tamil Nadu Teacher Education University, Professor Balakrishnan, renowned professors of Tamil Nadu Teacher Education University, dear teacher educators, and dear students, a warm greetings and good afternoon to one and all. to gather here to this wonderful online platform. The unique Teacher Education University and prestigious VOC College of Education jointly organized a 7-day national level enrichment program on holistic development of teachers from 1st August 2020 to 8th August 2020. First day, the very first day, Vice Chancellor of our university, Professor N. Panchanatham, holistically inaugurated the function, and he emphasized the significance of teachers' holistic development. Today, a very wonderful occasion, the most respected registrar, Professor V. Balakrishnan, validates the 7 days enrichment program, and also to be blessed our participants and my dear students. It is my great pleasure to welcome the most respected registrar, controller of examination, professors and participants from across the country, and also provide an opportunity to organize this 7 days enrichment program. VOC family, thanks. VOC College of Education family, thanks. From the bottom of the heart to the Tamil Nadu Teacher Education family for conducting this webinar, and also their tireless work and support to us. It is my immense pleasure to take this opportunity to introduce our distinguished chief guest, Professor V. Balakrishnan, the most reputed registrar, Tamil Nadu Teacher Education University, Chennai. Our registrar is the product of the great Annamalai University. While I'm talking about professor, the very famous word which reflects in my mind, what it is, think globally and act locally. Think globally and act locally. Our today's chief guest is such a wonderful person, integrated personality. He is very dedicated with his work, dedicated mind, and devotional commitment, of course. He thinks, always thinks globally, and depends upon the situation and the climate, he acts locally. Such a fantastic personality, our chief guest. Our chief guest is very simple and genuine, not only by words, but also the actions and also reactions. He's the man of values and virtues, no doubt at all. Basically, he is the zoologist, very much interested with a human living, humanitarian, very good humanitarian. Our chief guest occupied several important positions such as dean of faculty, professors, including the member of many functional committees of universities. He has actually involved in research activities and published n number of articles in reputed journals at national as well as international level. Our chief guest has organized various academic and research programs under his dynamic leadership. Now I humbly introduce our distinguished chief guest, the most respected Professor V. Balakrishnan, Registrar of Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University, to address the gathering. Please, sir. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you for your warm welcome, sir. Now it's a honor to welcome our chief guest, Professor V. Balakrishnan, Registrar in Charge, Tamil Nadu Teacher Education University, to propose the valedictory address. Over to you, sir.
Dear President, good afternoon to all of you. At the outset,
good afternoon, sir.
At the outset, let me thank the Almighty for giving me an opportunity to deliver valedictory address on this auspicious occasion of validation ceremony of 7-day national online enrichment program on holistic development of the teachers, jointly organized by Pauzi College of Education and the Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University. First of all, let me thank our honorable Vice Chancellor for motivating and encouraging the teaching faculty of Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University and its affiliated colleges of education to organize this type of national and international workshop, seminar, and conferences, and so on. I feel immensely happy to offer my special congratulations and wishes to the organizing secretaries, Dr. P. N. S.V. Sanmugam, Dr. S. Tarasubha, the convener of this seminar, Dr. T. Kanagaraj, the principal of Pauzi College of Education, and Dr. M. Govindan, the dean of faculty, control of exam at Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University, and also the members of this 1-week workshop consisting of Dr. M. Sendil Kumaran, Mrs. T. Usharnandini, Dr. S. Guru Vasuhi, Dr. S. Andoni, Mrs. M. Karida, Mrs. G. Kirija, and Mrs. P. Kiriya, and all others directly, indirectly involved in the wonderful program on holistic development of the teacher. The 7-day online enrichment program on holistic development of teachers has dealt with various aspects of teacher education, such as the learner's psychology, the transcending teachers from individual to person, the ethics of teachers, teachers as a leader, the digital interactive tools, passion for learning and teaching, and good communication skills. All these topics are need of the hours. Once again, I congratulate the organizing team for organizing this wonderful need-based program. The first theme, learner psychology, focuses on various psychological theories. The teachers need to understand the principles of psychology proposed by the various psychologists, starting from the Thorndike, Pavlov, Skinner, belonging to behaviorism, then the cognitivists such as the Gagne, John Dewey, then a humanist consisting of a number of psychologists, the famous psychologists belonging to humanist are Maslow, Rogers, and Roth et al. And so on. The teachers need to understand all the principles proposed by the various psychologists. Then the second aspect, transcending teachers from individual to person. The teachers needs to transcend from the individuality to personality. The term individual refers to the person who is possessing the dominant I feeling. What is the difference between individual and person? The human being who are possessing dominant I feeling is known as individual. On the contrary, the man or human being who are possessing the we feeling is known as person. In Tamil, there is one technical term in Sanskrit, purusartha. In English, it is person. In Sanskrit, it is a purusartha. There are purusartha means goals, objectives. There are four goals for each human being to be achieved in his lifetime: the artha, kama, dharma, and moksha. If a human being consisting of all these goals is known as person. In Indian context, the holistic development refers to the development of integrated personality. Integrated personality is analyzed as consisting of five sheath or covering. The five sheath or covering refers to divinity, which is at the very core of the personality. The five sheath are of physical self. The outermost layer represents the physical dimension, the way we look, our body, bones, and the flesh. The next sheath is known as energy self. It represents the energy dimension that puts the body into action. The third covering or sheath is the mental self. This layer represents the mental dimension, what we know of various subjects, science, humanities, mathematics, world affairs, our writing skills, and the experience we gather in life. All this go into forming our mental dimension. The next dimension is known as intellectual self. It represents the intellectual aspect of the personality. This takes decision, what is to be done, what is right, what is wrong, what is not to be done. It discriminates between right and wrong. The last dimension is known as blissful self. It represents the blissful dimension. It manifests as joy felt in sleep or when absorbed in art, music, anything that takes our total dimension. To sum up, the holistic development consists of the various aspects, the dimension of personality. The dimension of personality varies from the person to person. For example, according to Mahatma Gandhi, the integrated personality consists of mind, body, and spirit. He says that the education is nothing but the process of all-round drawing out of the best in the child, Kaivan, mind, body, mind, and spirit. According to Swami Vivekananda, we want that education by which character is formed, strength of the mind is increased, intellect is expanded, by which one can stand on by one's own feet. This is the three dimension proposed by the Swami Vivekananda. Likewise, the dimensions of integrated personality is differ from one person to another person. But in Indian context, the integrated personality, the holistic personality, should consist of physical, energy, mental, intellectual, and blissful dimension. beyond this five dimension is our divine self, the core of our personality. The body is born, therefore it will die. Divine is something that is eternal. It is something that never born and shall never die. We are all familiar with the suffering, pain and unhappiness. Divinity is the core of the personality that has no suffering, no pain, and is the source of eternal bliss. Just as the core of our personality is the divinity, the very basis of personality development is character. Character is some total of tendencies we acquire through repeated thoughts and actions. What we are now is a result of what we thought and did in the past. It flows that our present thoughts and action can shape our future. We must therefore ensure that our thought and action are noble and positive and constructive and inspiring. There is a saying, sow a thought, reap an action. Sow an action, reap a habit. Sow a habit, reap a character. Sow a character, reap a destiny. Character is a repeated habits. Habits are nothing but our action, performed again and again over a period of time. Actions are performed by our thoughts. It is simplest question of cause and effect. Therefore, we have to be extremely careful about the thoughts and thoughts that enter our mind. Swami Vivekananda rightly says, whatever you think that you will be. If you think you are yourself weak, you will be. If you think yourself strong you will be. Character to be stable must rest on foundation of Panchasila. The Panchasila are the five basic concepts that are fundamental to the character, such as self-confidence, self-reliance, self-knowledge, self-control, self-sacrifice. The teachers needs to equip themselves all these dimensions of the characters. Then the teachers needs to use various social media such as Twitter, WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube, etc., as well as print and electronic media during the curriculum transaction for the dissemination of knowledge and skills to the students' community effectively and efficiently. நவில்தோறும் நூல் நயம்போலும் பயில்தோறும் பண்புடையாளர் தொடர்பு என்னும் வள்ளுவர் வாக்கிற்கேற்ப மாசற்ற உயர்குடியில் பிறந்தவரின் குடியுரிமை பண்புகளான நடுவுநிலைமை, நாணம், ஒழுக்கம், வாய்மை, முகமலர்ச்சி, ஈகை, இனிய சொல், சேவை, துண்டு, அன்பு, பணிவு, செருக்கு இல்லாமை, சான்றாமை போன்ற நற்பண்புகள் அனைத்தையும் வளர்த்து கொண்டு மாநகர சமூகத்திற்கு சேவை செய்ய இந்த கருத்தரங்கு மூலம் வாய்ப்பு வழங்கிய முனைவர் லட்சுமி சமூகத்திற்கும் வாவுசி கல்லூரியுடைய முதல்வருக்கும் மீண்டும் ஒரு முறை வாட்சியில் தெரிவித்துக் கொண்டு விடைபெற்றுக் கொள்கிறேன். நன்றி வணக்கம்.
நன்றி ஐயா. நன்றி ஐயா. நன்றி.
Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you, sir, for your effective and informative address. Now it is time for feedback. I request Mr. Nageshwara Rao, Assistant Professor, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar University, Andhra Pradesh, to give his feedback. Welcome, sir.
Madam, you can please call another participant. Ma'am, sir is not in.
Okay, okay, okay. Okay, next I call upon Ms. Kasturi Shesha Kamalam, who is a student teacher of biological science, Kamadhenu College of Education.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Good afternoon, one and all present here. Myself, Kasturi Sheshakamalam from Kamadhenu College of Education, E-Road from Tamil Nadu. Before feedback, I want to say something. Coming together is the beginning. Keeping together is a progress. Working together is a success. For success, teamwork is important. Teamwork makes the dream work. The 7-day online enrichment program, holistic development of teacher, the organizers' teamwork make us the dream work very successfully. So I want to say thank you to all. First of all, I thank you to Tamil Nadu Teacher Education University Vice Chancellor Sir Dr. N. Panchanadam Sir, respected Register Sir, and then respected Principal of VOC College of Education Dr. T. Kanagaraj Sir for very honorable support for this program. And also thank you to all 70 resource person who fulfill this program. The best teacher teach from the heart, not from the book. All 7 resource person, they teach from this from their heart. Next, the organizer secretary Dr. P.N. Lakshmi Shanmugam ma'am, Dr. S. Davasubam ma'am, and all organizing joint secretaries for their big contribution. Now time for feedback. Educating the mind without educating the heart is no education at all. The mind, heart of us, learns so many delightful and marvelous things from this program. Knowledge, experience, examples, skills, techniques, etc. All 7-day program make our soul so colorful like rainbow. The 7 rainbow colors definitely make colorful life of our students in future, like teachers like us, because we are now fully holistically developed by this program. We want more webinars, especially for teacher trainee like me. We will support for you and your team. We want more webinar like this. Thank you once again. Thank you so much. Really inspiring session for me. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your wonderful feedback. Next, I call Ms. Manikyavalli, BT Assistant of Government Girls Higher Secondary School, Kundrathur, Kanjipuram, to give his feedback. Welcome, ma'am.
Greetings, ma'am. Am I audible? Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. You are audible.
Greetings to you all. Be blessed always. First of all, I thank great divine power for giving me this wonderful opportunity to meet you all. Then I thank VOC College and TNTU for arranging this program, which is very useful for all of us, like teachers, student teachers, and etc. Then I come to the program schedule. On first day, Dr. Yampi Ganesh, Associate Professor, Department of Liberal Arts, IIT Hyderabad, taught us on learner psychology. Without learner psychology, we can't teach effectively to the students, isn't it? According to that, he taught us very useful point to us. Undoubtedly, it was a wonderful session to all of us. We have to accept that indeed. On next day, Dr. S. Razul Mohideen, Associate Professor in English, VOC College of Education, Thoothukudi, presented on transcending teachers from individual to person. Yes, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world, isn't it? I hope you will all agree. From his presentation, we all came to know that education is the most useful powerful weapon in the world to change the community, particularly students. On third day, Professor Virojeswari, former head, Department of Education, Mother Teresa Women's University, Kodaikanal, presented on ethics of teachers. Very useful topic today, because most of the persons, including academicians, are in the negative media, because the media has a more powerful weapon. It has a more individual, noble qualities in it. But most of the persons use the media for negative feedback, negative impact. So automatically the ethics comes down. So the ethics of teachers is the very, very essential topic for today's world. So the ethics of teachers concept was taught by Professor Virojeshwari in the excellent manner. Hats off to you, ma'am. On the fourth day, Dr. Vishri Devi had an associate professor, Department of Chemistry, Lady Doe College, Madurai, discussed with us on teacher as a leader. Yes, very proud moment. We are a leader. Because most of the teachers feel themselves as an inferior to some others that become leaders and officials. They don't feel themselves as a, they are also leader. They are also leaders, but they don't feel like that. What do you do for it? It's the psychological imbalance. So first of all, we have to feel that we are the leaders of students also and also the society. For this community and the great nation, we are the leaders. Yes, we are the leaders of leaders. On the fifth day, Professor N. Ramakrishnan, member of syndicate, has Department of Educational Technology, Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University, presented on digital interactive tools. Excellent session or soft user, because this world has changed into digital manner. Nobody could live without digital age, because this era belongs to digital. We are in the digital age. So that digital interactive tools presented by Professor N. Ramakrishnan was very useful to us. On next day, which is sixth day, Dr. J. Bennett Rojathurai, Assistant Professor in Sociology, Bishop Caldwell College, Thoothukudi, shared with us on passion for learning and teaching. Without passion, you couldn't succeed in the world, isn't it? We should have passion in us. We should have passion on students. Without passion, we couldn't love learning as well as teaching. So that topic inculcated more values to us. Thank you, sir. On the last day today, good communication skills taught by our beloved Kingston Assistant Professor in Commerce, USA College, Thoothukudi. Being a commerce professor, he taught English very nice. His English was very fluent, which is appreciable by all of us. Thank you, Kingston, sir, for your wonderful session. Last but not least, I thank Dr. Devasubha, ma'am. First of all, I was not able to register in the USC college. Then I called Devasubha, ma'am. I am very fond of USC. I am attending so many national seminars and international seminars and getting so many certificates daily. But I want to get a blessing from VOC through getting certificate, because I am a true follower of VOC. I told her, undoubtedly, as I'm not in the group also, daily she's sending me messages to my personal number of link and everything and PowerPoint. I can't believe in the world, such a wonderful person in the world. What a wonderful person, Devasubha, ma'am. What's up to you? I don't want to admire your technical skills and academic skills, but I want to admire your humanity skills. In this world, the person like you are very essential. Hope all will agree with me. Thank you. Thank you, one and all, and all the organizers of the team. Thank you so much for the very wonderful opportunity. Be blessed always.
Thank you, ma'am, for your motivational words. Next, anyone else? Dava, ma'am? Dava, ma'am?
No, ma'am.
Okay. It's an honor itself to honor this beautiful audience who have gathered here With regard to this, I call upon Dr. P.N. Lakshmi Shanmugam, Assistant Professor in Educational Psychology, Tamil Nadu Teacher Education University, to propose the vote of thanks. Ma'am, over to you.
Yes. Good morning. Good afternoon to you all. I deem it a great honor to propose the vote of thanks to all who have helped us in making this 7-day online enrichment program on holistic development of teachers organized by Training and Placement Cell, Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University and VOC College of Education, Tuticorin, such a resounding success. First of all, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to our Honorable Vice Chancellor for his kind support by giving thought-provoking inaugural address and gracing this webinar program. I would like to express my sincere thanks to the most respected registrar in charge, Professor V. Balakrishnan, Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University, for his great support towards the growing faculty members like us. He is so simple and has the helping tendency. He has given many opportunities to build our competences in our profession. He is always impartial. As a good human, he is ready to give immediate help at his level towards our growth. Thank you, sir, for your continuous motivation, encouragement, and your thought-provoking valedictory address, which helps to summarize the holistic development of teachers. This program is completely fulfilled by your effective and exemplary address, sir. We are gifted to have you in this webinar, sir. Thank you, sir. I would like to express my sincere thanks to the Controller of Examination in charge and Dean of Faculty, Professor A.M. Govindan, Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University, for his marvelous support. I would like to express our profound gratitude to the President, Sri APCV Chokkalingam, Sri APCV Shanmugam, Secretary, and Dr. T. Kanagaraj, Principal, VOC College of Education, for their kind support. We are also grateful to all the resource persons, Dr. M. Ganesh, for giving webinar on learner psychology, Dr. S. Razul Mohaidin, for giving webinar on transcending teachers from individual to person, Professor V. Rajeshwari, for giving webinar on ethics of teachers, Dr. V. Sridevi, for giving webinar on teacher as a leader, Professor N. Ramakrishnan, for giving webinar on digital interactive tools, Dr. J. Bennett Rajadurai, for giving webinar on passion for learning and teaching. Mr. A. Kingston, for giving webinar on good communication skills. All the sessions were very useful and informative. We extend our sincere thanks to you. In spite of this lockdown situation, you were able to give the session. I would like to thank all the participants who made this session a successful one. Hope this session was very useful to you all. You are the backbone for the success of this program. Thank you all for your excellent cooperation. I would like to thank the organizing secretary, Dr. S. Davashubha, Assistant Professor in Mathematics, VOC College of Education, and joint organizing secretaries, Dr. M. Sendil Kumaran, Assistant Professor in Educational Technology, Mrs. T. Usha Nandini, Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University, Dr. S. Guruvashagi, Dr. S. Antony Vinolia, Ms. C. Grija, Ms. M. Kavita, Ms. P. Priya, Assistant Professors, VOC College of Education, for their moral support, and all other supporters working as Assistant Professors in VOC College of Education, Dr. G. Amudaranjani, Ms. R. Rufina Dhanasudha, Dr. M. Dhanavadi. Before concluding the session, I request everyone be safe and secure. Once again, I would like to express my sincere thanks to you all on behalf of the organizing members of Training and Placement Cell, Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University and VOC College of Education, Tuticorin. Once again, I thank you all for your cordial cooperation. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your honest gratitude. The best thing about being a teacher is that it matters. The hardest thing about being a teacher is that it matters every day. So I thank you one and all for your inclusive cooperation and support throughout our journey for these 7 days. Let us take these 7 days for vibrant rainbow colors during our lifetime successfully.
Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot for your great support and moral support. Sir,
sir, just now, sir, left the meeting. So, on behalf of VOC College of Education, our faculty members, and the Tamil Nadu Teacher Education University and their faculty, I would like to thank all the participants who just supported who gave your support and for your cooperation. We thank you all. So see you all with another session. We are overwhelmed with your positive responses, and we will try to give so many very good programs. So be connected with us. Thank you for joining with us. Thank you all. See you in another program. Thank you, dear participants. And I personally thank Kasturi ma'am and Manikavalli ma'am for their valuable feedback. Thank you. Lakshmi ma'am?
Lakshmi madam.
Yes, sir.
Madam.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Keep in touch.
Sure, sir.
In the inauguration session also, our Honorable Vice Chancellor will give a permission.
Okay.
Yeah, for leading another program and continuous program. Not only another, continuous program. Yeah, thanks a lot, sir. Thank you, Razul Mugaidin, sir. Thank you for your great support, senior faculty members. I thank all the senior faculty members.
Thank you, madam.
Yeah,
thank
for you. Your great support, sir.
So you gave the permission in collaboration with our university, we could conduct the program.
Yeah.
So on behalf of our principal.
Because of affinity as an alumnus, sir.
Of course.
Yeah. I would like to express my sincere thanks to all the team of VOC College of Education faculty members.
Thank you. Mr. Subramaniam, you are also one of the alumni.
Yeah. First,
thank you, Principal, sir.
Yeah. Davasubhaman, thanks a lot.
Thank you, Madam. Thank you, Lakshmi, Madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you,
one and all. Thank you very much, Professor.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everybody, including principal. Dava, again, you proved yourself, and you have to prove a lot in the days to come. Okay, nice program you have organized.
Thank you, sir.
So everybody has to be appreciated. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank our principal also. Thank you, sir.
So participants, thank you for your cooperation that you gave us for all these 7 days, and we are expecting the same for the upcoming programs too. So thank you for joining with us. So see you all in another program. So now we shall leave the room. So I request all the participants to leave the room, and the certificates will be issued within 2 or 3 days. So we still need your cooperation regarding the certificate too. Thank you so much. Thank you all. So participants, you can leave the room.
There are a good number of participants. They are participating all our programs.
Yes, sir.
Even when you are asked to leave, they wanted to listen our chatting also. I hope that they also enjoy the things. Okay.
So we have a signature closing. You know, we used to chat at the end of the session. So many enjoyed that session, it seems.
That session itself, they are silently enjoying all the things.
Yes, of course.
Our well wishers are also there. Many alumni are also there.
Yes,
sir. Mr. Armugarajan is there. Is Armugarajan online?
No, sir. No. Actually, today he faced a lot of network issue.
Okay, Armugarajan, a good number of other people also, our own students, our own students. So everybody deserves the word of appreciation, and they deserve our gratitude also. Okay, thank you.
Exactly, sir.
Okay. Have you stopped the recording?
Sir,
Dava ma'am?
Yes, now just now this second sir